I could
say that question.
The questionnaire is there. Yeah. Never
sing a blue. A lot of people are turning up early, which is good. And tickets and stuff. Sold out, so.
Completely sold out.
Completely.
Is it 10 euros? Is it? Oh, wait a second. What the f? What the f? Yeah. Making fun of you, it's playing a trick on you. It's only a piece of paper. Oh, this is French. It says, it's just playing a trick on you.
Translation.
Yeah. Yeah. Look how it controls you. It controls you. It's just playing a trick on your mind. Don't be a slave.
So, yeah, that's it. This is what we have to do after Z-Day. A two-month period of Operation Money Crackdown.
I uploaded the editable version.
Yes. Everywhere in the world. Yes, oh, I saw it. We have to make it worldwide. We have to gather all the videos on a Dropbox, and then we have to make a collaborative video to go viral on YouTube.
It's so much data. It's with so much data, and it comes from so many different angles that you're left with more or less a confused feeling. But he draws conclusions throughout the entire thing. So these conclusions are hit, but they're not really convinced based on the data that's set up.
It's astounding. This book goes all the way through, and it's kind of like, obviously everybody needs money to survive, but bonuses on her, they're really nice, because that elicits people, that's a reward mechanism. And I'm like, what the hell
is this? I think Scooter goes, and Christians grew up to think our God is right. But I mean, on the end,
But I'll reach the sky. I could end my story in a blaze of glory.
And I'm afraid my disposition is the same as it was 75 years ago. This shit's got to go.
Enjoy the communist propaganda.
How many times do you have to hear that?
The logic is undeniable. There's no two ways about it.
All right. The faces. I hear members talking about this also. And then we have phase one and phase two. And the other day, a guy told me, Gilbert, I'm not gonna get active till phase two. I'm gonna wait phase one out. And I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? I'm sorry, Paul, if there's any small children, I'm sorry that this even came up, this faces thingy. It's not relevant. You know what's relevant for us? This, phase one. That's not it, sorry. Awareness. That's the task of the Zeitgeist movement. Communication. Making sure we get the message out. We're not out there to build cities. This has been reiterated so many times. We're about communicating this message. The rest of the phase is irrelevant. Don't want to hear about it anymore. All right, just to finish it up, really quickly, I'd like to invite some people on the stage. Federico Pistoro, our Italian coordinator. Because I've been standing here like talking as if I'm doing this by myself. Obviously I'm not. These are great people. They spend their time coordinating their countries. They're doing a lot of work. So guys, could you really briefly just say how you've been experiencing activism in the movement so far? 30 seconds each, I'm gonna rush you. Thank you.
Okay, try to be brief. Hello everybody, I'm Federico from Italy, and I started to coordinate about a year and a half ago the Italian chapter. It's been a great adventure, and it still is. And I just want to tell you one thing in my 30 seconds, which is you need to have fun. Okay, if you're not having fun, it's not worth saving the world.
Yeah.
We have to enjoy it. Otherwise, we can.
Hello, my name is Marto. I'm the European Chapters Coordinator. I also coordinate a chapter in my city, in Slovakia. The name of the city is Nitra. And from my experience, the beginnings are always very hard when you're starting a chapter, starting like in coordination. So when we're still young, so we have a lot to do on all levels, I guess. And unless a lot of people realize how hard they need to work, and shouldn't take things for granted, we won't see much change, I guess. So, thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Miguel Oliveira, and I coordinate the Portugal chapter. Just wanted to say in my 30 seconds that it's very important to not only have fun, but actually accomplish stuff while having fun. Because that's really art. People often forget to really organize things, but it's possible to have fun and organize, and something that we all should do. Because when we look back, we see that we accomplished great things, like our progression so far. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Frankie. I'm the coordinator of German-speaking chapters. I'd like to welcome everybody here that you show up. It's good to see that this movement is not just an online phenomenon, so let's work together and get this in the offline world. And there's a quote in Germany that says, much learning does not teach us understanding. And also Einstein said, every fool can know, but the point is to understand. So let's try to work on this more and more. We're all in the process, we all took the red pill and everything. So let's try to achieve a world without poverty, politics, and war. And glad that you all made it.
All right. So thank you very much. If you have any questions about chapters in the breaks, just hit me up. We'll talk about it. If you want to start a chapter in your local area, send me an email, gilbert@designguysmovement.com. I'll let you know. If you want to dance salsa, I'm outside, so really
thank you. Okay, everybody, we're wrapping it up now. Peter's going to say a few words. We're sorry about Jacques and Roxanne. We've had technical problems trying to get hold of them. Peter will say something about why they're not here as well. Thank you all for coming. I hope it's been educational. I hope you've enjoyed it. I hope you feel that, you know, something you've learned here today is going to change the way you, when you go through those doors, you're going to maybe make a different move in your life, you know, try and change the way things are. We really got to do this. We're all in this together. We're going to change or we're going to die. It's as simple as that, okay? And I'd just like to thank the Quaker group for letting us hold this meeting here. It's very kind of them. They're very decent people. And on one final little bit of kudos, I don't know if any of you know the history of this building, but I think it was about 80 years ago, you can Google it, A certain individual called Mohandas K. Gandhi spoke in this room on this stage just before he went back to dismantle the British Empire with a stick and a dhoti. So I think we're going in the right direction.
I think Tom paraphrased a lot of what I'd like to say. I want all of our speakers to stand up. How many chapter coordinators do we have here that have come from afar? Please stand up. These individuals have taken their time, doing a fantastic job across the world. How many people here are active within the movement and something that they actively engage? Well, thank you. And for everyone else that this information might be new, I hope that this vast spectrum of information, which I think, if you're not familiar with it, obviously it could be very overloading, but it really beautiful that all of us have come together for this, and I'm just so outrageously pleased, and I hope those of you that are digesting this information will take the time to follow through, not get too complacent with the kind of, well, miserable existence that tends to persist out there, not feel like you don't have the time because of all the pressures of this society, mainly artificial. Believe me, I understand. So it takes another level of energy to pursue this type of thing. It's not easy. We're engaged in the most difficult move, again, probably in the history of humankind. So it takes a strength and courage. And for all of you that will continue to pursue this, I'm here for you. I hope you're here for me. Love you all. Get home safe.